Okay, so class, so good afternoon. So our lesson for today is all about counting principles, no? So we'll discuss 8 theorems for this afternoon. Okay, so let's start. So I already sent in our GC the files that you need for today, no? Okay, please open this. If you have your gadgets there, if you have your computer, you may open also this. Okay, for those students na gumagamit na ng cellphone, you just look at your screen. No? I am sharing the screen. Okay, I am opening a PowerPoint presentation. Okay, so let's start. makita man ano, nakashare ako, lumukso.
Yes po,
nakashare
sir.
Ako, no? Okay, so our topic for today is about counting principles. Okay, so first theorem, again, there are 8 theorems. No? Multiplication rule, if an operation can be formed in n sub 1 ways, and if for each of this, a second operation can be performed in n sub 2 ways, then the two operations can be performed together in n sub 2 times n sub 1 times n sub 2. Okay, for example, how many sample points are in the sample space when a pair of dice is thrown once? So automatically, okay, n sub 1 is the first die. Okay, it has 6 possible outcomes or outputs, no? 1 to 6, and the second object, okay, in this case the second die, n sub 2, okay, has also 6 possible outcomes or output, no? So you say that n sub 1 is equal to 6, okay, n sub 2 is equal to 6. Use the formula 6 times 6, so therefore there are 36 ways or possible outcomes or sample points, okay, if you will perform that experiment. So again, this is counting principle, no? So let us open the whiteboard. I already prepared this whiteboard, no? Or our sort of our blackboard, no? So okay. Now, what do you mean by this counting principle? No? Before we discuss regarding the probability, okay, I told you that probability has a general formula, okay, small n divided by capital N, this formula. Okay, this can be expressed in a decimal or fraction or ratio, no? Or in percentage. So yung counting principles, tinatanong lang tayo kung ilan yung elements or sample points nasa denominator, yung sa baba, or nasa numerator, yung sa itaas. In short, bibilangin lang natin. So first theorem, okay, you're asked, no? Ilan ba yung possible outcomes with that kind of experiment? You are asked to throw 2 dice at a time, no? Or once. So ilan ang possible outcomes nun? So using the formula, okay, just say, just use n sub 1 times n sub 2 or 6 times 6, that will give you 36. Now, to convince you na yung talagang dapat na formula, okay, can you look at your screen, no? So in tree diagram, okay, we will write S, right? The first die, okay, has 6 possible outcomes. Okay, that is why we have the 6 branches here. Okay, so you label 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, it says there 2 dice. Okay, so yung ika-second die, merong 6 possible outcomes. That is why, itong one branch mo, meron siyang branch na is na nakakabit na 6. Okay? What you mean by this? If yung first die mo, ang makita mo dun sa top ng kanyang surface is 1, you need to read the second die. Okay? Now, there are 6 possible outcomes. What if ang nakita mo sa second die is 1, So you say, okay, 1-1, right? 1-1. Okay, makita mo doon sa surface, sa top ng die, sa cube na, yun, no? Okay, makita mo 1. Okay? Then sa second die, makita mo 1 din. Okay? So that's only one outcome or sample point, no? Bibilang mo isa lang. Okay? Possible din siya. Okay, pag throw mo, nakita mo sa first die 1. Then sa second die 2. Remember this is this are chance or ano no, experiment, no? So huwag kayong malito, sir. Marami lagi masyadong sanga-sanga yan, sir. Akala ko dalawa lang yung dice na yan. It's always or, okay? What if, okay? So yun yung mga what if natin. So ilan yung possible outcomes natin. O pwede din, pag throw mo, okay, makita mo 1, then yung second die is 2. Okay? So tama lang nalagyan mo siya ng ganitong klaseng branches, no? 1, 2, that's the first, then 1, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. O pwede din na sa first die makita mo 2. Okay? Then may isang nga siya dito na 6 din. Okay? So pwede mo ma ang lalabas sa second die is 1. Okay? That's another outcome or sample points. So nakita na natin ang pattern, kada isang sanga, meron pang 6. So kung bibilangin natin manually, 1-1 isa, 1-2, 1 nag-double ata, no? Hindi ko ito na-correct ba? Okay, maybe this is 1-3. Okay? 1-3. Okay? Ika-third. Okay? 1-3, 1-4, 1-5, 1-6. Okay? Bilang natin. Possible din siya 2-1, ika-7, 2-2, ika-8, okay, hanggang ika-12 na 2-6. Okay? Kung gusto mo bilangin manually, okay, but that is not practical, no? So gagamitin natin diretso ng formula, which is 6 times 6 that will give us 36. I'm sure ang lalabas ito 36. Okay, that is theorem number 1. Now another example para ma-visualize natin ng maayos, let us create a example na simple lang, no? For example, you're asked to coin two coins, you need to flip once, no? Yung dalawang coins, i-flip mo ng isang beses. So, ano yung possible outcomes? Sa first coin, there are two outcomes ang possible, no? So, pwedeng lalabas is head or tail. Okay? Kapag head yung lalabas, meron ka pang isang coin. Yung possible to second coin mo, head and tail pa rin. Okay? Possible outcome, head-head. Okay? That's one. Okay? Possible din siya na sa first na muna coin, head. The second coin mo, tail. Head, tail. Ka-second. Okay? O pwede din, kung hindi lalabas yung head, sa first coin mo, lalabas tail. Okay? But you need to read the second coin. The possible head, tail, do sa second coin. So the third possible outcome is tail and head. And last, I think, a first coin, tail, then second coin is tail also. So TT. Okay? So, kung bibilangin natin manually, kay apat. But sabi ng theorem 1, huwag mo na yan bilangin. Okay? Huwag mo na siyang gawan ng tree diagram. Use directly the formula. Okay? So, using the formula, n is equal to n sub 1, okay? Times n sub 2. Ito yung formula ng ating theorem 1. Wala nga, may nag-PM ba? Sige lang, yung may problema sa internet, ano lang, ayun yung magka-stress, ah. Anyway, that this is recorded, no? Balik kayo yung recording mamaya. So, capital N is equal to 2 times 2. Okay? I use na lang open close parenthesis. So four ways. Okay? So hindi na tayo gumawa ng tree diagram or listing method. Just use the formula, no? Because this is counting principles. Okay? These are counting principles. Okay? We're done with theorem number one. Yan lang, ano ito? Bakit nag-apian ito isa? Sige lang, ayan. No problem. Naka-record ito. Okay, next tayo. The next theorem is generalized multiplication rule. It's multiplication rule pa rin siya. Okay? So, example. How many lunches are possible consisting of soup, a sandwich, dessert, and a drink if one can select from four soups, three kinds of sandwiches, and five desserts, and four drinks? Using the formula, okay, ganun pa rin siya, n sub 1 times n sub 2, okay, times n sub 3, hanggang kung ilan yung kinds, no? Now, so in short, itong theorem number is more on options, okay? Ano yung, ilan yung pwede mong ilagay, okay? So using this that formula, the same with theorem 1, that's 4 times 3 times 5 times 4, just simply multiply. So that will give you the outcomes of 240 ways or combinations, okay? Now, let us have a more simpler example. No? Let's go back with our whiteboard. Okay, so this is the example. Theorem 1. Can I ask somebody to please participate? Okay, sampo na lang kinaiwan. Aniseto, okay lang? May microphone ka? Aniseto?
Sir, sir?
Can I ask you? Okay, can you look at the screen, please?
Yes po.
Okay. Ganito ang situation na nasa ito, no? Pupunta ka ng sa simpleng karinderya lang. Yung karinderya na yun, nag-offer lang dalawang klaseng kanin. It could be either fried rice or plain rice. Okay?
Opo.
Now, dalawa lang yung klase ng ulam, chicken. It could be garlic chicken or butter chicken. Okay?
Opo.
Kindly enumerate lahat ng pwede mong combination na magkakaiba. Okay? I will give you one, no? First
Ay,
combination.
Alam ko na po, sir.
Yes,
so, sir. Ang first po, FG.
FG.
Tapos, FB. Tapos, PG. Tapos, PB.
Very good.
Yan po, sir. Four ways po.
Parang hindi nyo na kailangan na mag-lesson. Hindi na tayo mag-lesson class. Advanced is aniseto ba? Okay, so there are four ways or combination na pwede mong magawa, no? So in short, okay, alam na natin manually, okay, yung theorem to, huwag mo nang gawin ito kasi that will consume time, no? So gawin natin direct. So N is equal to, there are two types of rice times, okay, or two types of chicken. Okay. Automatically, that will give you four ways or outcomes. Okay, very good. Okay, theorem number three na tayo. Now, theorem number three, okay, the number of permutations of n distinct objects is n factorial. Plus, kindly bring out your calculator, yung scientific calculator nyo. Yung ganitong klaseng calculator, yung pangtindahan, wala itong factorial, no? So, mahirapan tayo later. Unless masinop kayo sa pag-solve because we all know that factorial means, for example, 3 factorial is equal to 3 times 2 times 1. Okay? If you have 10 factorial, that is 10 times 9 times 8 times 7, hanggang aabot ka ng times 1. Okay? That's the factorial. No? Balikan natin yung ating lesson sa ating basic na mathematics. Okay? Now, please take note that kapag permutation, okay, arrangement of all or part of a set of objects. Arrangement is important. Okay? Kasi later, maglilito kayo, ano bang pagkakaiba ng combination sa permutation, sir? Okay? So that's the main question later, no? So we'll have an example here. Okay? The number of permutations of four letters, okay, A, B, C, and D, is 4 factorial. Okay? Gamitin natin diretso yung formula given under theorem number 3. So therefore, using your calculator, can I ask somebody? Ilang, okay, ano lang class? We are recording, no? So no problem. Na-stress na yung classmates nyo ba, no? Abdullah, Sarikala, you have your calculator? Wala siya. Abdullah, wala. Jade, Adarna. Jade, any participate, Jade? Meron kang calculator dyan sa iyo? Scientific calculator? Meron, no? Okay. Palihog daw siya, ano? Kindly press 4 then factorial. Is it 24?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, another, huwag mo na mag-alis data. Theorem number 3 tayo. Okay, why not think of a more simpler example, no? Example, okay, kapag dalawa lang yung person, okay, let us name that person as A and B, okay? In how many ways you can arrange them distinctly? Okay, palagay mo, ilan? Person A, person B. Ilang ways mo ma-arrange yung dalawang tao sa dalawang upuan na magkaiba? Okay, mauna si A, right? Then followed by B, that's one, no? Then mauna si B, then followed by A, that's two. Okay, meron pa bang iba, Jade?
Wala na, sir.
Okay, kindly press 2 factorial, please. Is it 2? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 2. Okay, so yung simple na example, no? Now, Jade, in what situation, okay, na makonsider mo na hindi important yung A at saka B at saka B, at B or B and A? Meron ka bang maisip na scenario na magkapareho itong A at saka B at saka or B or A, okay? Disregarding sa arrangement niya. Kasi yung madalas ng question ng student is, sir, paano kung malaman na hindi siya permutation? Okay? So in short, combination siya. May isip ka ba scenario, Jade, na they're the same? Wala? Pass?
Okay.
Okay, how about the others?
Magkapareho, sir?
Magkapareho sila. Kumbaga, wala namang diferensyang A, A, B, at saka B, A, B, A eh. Okay? Yung ating scenario kanina sa upuan, no? Arrangement niya. Kumbaga, kung unang upuan, nasa harapan, nasa likod yung isa. So, pag-analyze natin, they are different. Kung mauna ka sa harapan, then siya sa likod, okay, that's one. Kung mauna siya sa harapan, ikaw sa likod, that's two. Okay? Yun yung mga scenario that permutation siya. Ibig sabihin, arrangement is important. Okay? Now, the question is that, paano, anong scenario that the arrangement is not important? May maisip kang scenario? Jade? Wala. How about wala, no? How about the others? Okay, can I ask you na lang, Jade? Jade? Kapag na kay Uyab, yun na ka ba Uyab? O sa pangalan sa imong Uyab, Jade? O wala? Secret? Okay. For example, imong uyab, Jade, si Janet, no? Jade at saka Janet, uyab mong dawa, no? difference kung mauna, kung tingnan ako, mag-uyab si Janet o si Jade, may difference kung mag-mention ko Jade, Janet, then Janet, Jade. May difference, wala?
Wala, sir.
So, ibig sabihin, mag-uyab, yapon ng dawa, right? Pag magsabihin ko Jade and Janet, then mauna si Janet at saka Jade, it's the same. Okay? So in short, in that scenario, it's not important kung mauna ko i-mention ikaw o siya. Kaya ang scenario, mag-uyab mo dili. So ibig sabihin, it's only one, no? Isa na siya accounting, no? Another example, kapag combination siya, if you consider yung options nyo as equally qualified. Okay? For example, no? Nag-back to face-to-face tayo, tapos nag-meeting tayo sa CAT, and you are, for example, one of you is the chairman, no? Kumuha kayo ng representante ng representative per year level. If you consider all the year level, per year levels, so students sa per year level na yan, are equally qualified, magmamatter ba kung sino yung tao? Again, we have the assumption here na all okay, na nasa year levels na yun, estudyante, for example, kayo, second year kayo lahat, no? You have equally, for example, in terms of talent, no? Equal kayo lahat. In terms of intelligence, equal kayo lahat. Mag-matter ba, Jade, kung sino ilagay natin? Jade? Wala ka na, Jade?
Dili,
no? So, yun yung mga scenario class that hindi siya permutation. Okay? So, malalaman natin later, no? Kasi that is theorem number 8. Okay na, Jade. Okay, next. Can I ask James Rian Riboho? James?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, theorem number 3 pa rin tayo, no? Let us prove again na tama yung ating formula. There are 3 balls, okay? In how many ways you can arrange them distinctly? Okay? Kindly enumerate all.
Anong 3 balls, sir, na yung...
Tatlong bolan, magkakaibang color. Kinasa screen, red, yellow, tsaka blue, no? In how many ways you can arrange them? Kindly enumerate all of them, please. Okay, you can only see red.
Red, yellow, blue,
okay.
Tapos yellow.
Para mag-systematize tayo, red pa rin, then followed by?
Blue.
Blue, okay, very good. Then followed
Then red. Yellow, sir.
Yellow. Okay. Next.
Then red. Yellow. Yellow, then red.
Red.
Then blue.
Blue, very good. Next.
Then blue.
Yellow pa rin para mag-systemize.
Ah, sige. Yellow. Blue.
Blue, very good. Next.
Then red.
Okay. Next.
Then blue.
Blue.
Red.
Red.
Yellow.
Okay, yellow. Next.
Then blue, yellow, at red, sir.
Blue, yellow,
red.
And red. Okay. Meron pa bang iba? Wala na. Meron pa ba iba? Wala na.
Sana siya iba, sir.
Okay, nandiyan na lahat. Okay? So, nag-agree lahat, nandiyan na lahat. So, kung bibilang natin counting principles tayo, okay, there are 6 no, outcomes. So let us prove kung tama talaga yung theorem na yun. Okay? It says, okay, bilangin natin objects, there are 3 balls na magkakaiba yung color, no? So 3, n is equal to 3. You can use your calculator. Okay, 3 factorial is equal to 6 ways. Okay? Kung wala kayong calculator sa ngayon, okay, remember in our basic mathematics, no? Ang 3 factorial is equal to 3 times 2 times 1. Okay? Ayaw, klaro tayo sa factorial, no? Okay, very good. Okay, James. May calculator ka, James?
Meron,
James,
sir.
James, 3 yan.
Yo, meron,
can
sir.
Can you press 0 factorial, please? 0 factorial.
1, sir.
Okay. Okay, klaro, class, ha? According kay James, 3 yan, that 0 factorial is using the calculator is always equal to 1. Okay, baka kasi may mag-answer sa atin na 0. Okay? Now, maybe some of you or all of you board course kayo, no? Is ano grupo niyo gani, James Rian? EE kayo, no?
EE, sir.
Okay, class, please, kung wala mo yung calculator, magpalit mo calculator na ginaalaw sa board exam. Okay, magawas ba ni ano, sir, kaning mga statistics, sir? Magawas ang uban. Okay, ang uban, basic math, no, aside sa inyong major. Okay, so in short, ayun na mo gamit og manual. Okay, maalangan mo sa oras basta yung board exam. Okay, let's proceed now. Okay, next ko na tatawagin is si James Robert Arquio. Okay, James Robert, okay, later na lang, ha, after ito. Okay, the next theorem is theorem number 4. Okay, the number of permutation of n distinct objects taken R at a time is, okay, NPR is equal to n factorial divided by open close parenthesis, okay, n minus r with factorial. Okay, intindihin na lang natin or ang r as slot, no? Okay, huwag kayong mag-react. Baka iba sa iba yung meaning ng slot sa inyo ba? Yung slot na spelling is ganito, ha. Iba kasi yung meaning ng slot na isang yung U, no? Okay, medyo bastos talaga yun, no? Ito, okay? Itong meaning ng itong spelling ng slot, ha? Kasi paglalagyan niya ba, the space na pwede mo ilagay, no? Slot, R, slot, okay? Next. Example tayo. Two lottery tickets are drawn from 20 for the first and second prize. Find the number of sample points in the sample space. Okay, James Arquio? James?
Yes, sir.
Okay, ilang objects lahat? Ilang distinct objects lahat? Sa example natin, can you look at the screen, please?
Sorry, sir. Dili kayo na ako siya mag-gets, sir.
Okay. Again, I will read, no? Two lottery tickets are drawn from 20 for the first and second prize. Okay. Find the number of sample points in the sample space. The first question is for you to identify ilan bang objects lahat. Minsan, ang objects is person, no? So, in this, I think in this case, it's a ticket, no? Ilang tickets lahat. Mahirap pa din statement. Drawn from. Okay? So, the situation is, for example, mag-draw tayo. Okay? Draw tayo ng first and second prize. Okay? So, ilan ang participants? James? Nakalagay?
20, sir.
Okay, 20. Okay? 20 tickets na ilagay sa biolo. Okay? So, there are 20 distinct objects. So, therefore, N is equal to 20. Ilang slots o paglalagyan, James?
Two, sir.
Okay, dalawa. Okay? May calculator ka, James Arquio? Na ano?
Wala po, sir.
Ay, wala. Okay, class. Yung may calculator, can I ask na lang siguro? Kasi I discourage you to use this formula. It will take time, no? Okay, can I ask?
Itry na ako sa calculator, sir.
Vince na lang, Vince. Vince Aston. Okay, can we press 20. Then hanapin niyo sa science.
Kuha na ako itong P, sir. Itong 20, tapos P, tapos 2.
Okay.
380 so, ni Goss.
Okay, so very good, no? So, may nakakuha sa classmates nyo. I hope next time meron na tayong scientific calculator class, ha? Kasi need talaga sa engineering, especially sa EE. Okay? Now, in manual, kailangan ko pa rin siya i-discuss kahit I strongly advise you to use the calculator. So, ganito siya sa manual. Okay? For some students, sir, bakit error? It's because nakalimutan yung lagyan ng open-close parenthesis. Kahit i-manual nyo siya, using the formula, I mean, dapat answer nyo is 380 ways. Okay? So, in the formula, this 20 factorial, 20 minus 2 would give you 18. Okay, that's so 18 factorial. Kahit siguro, okay, for example, I think in this case, you can solve this visually, no, mentally. Because we all know that 20 factorial is equal to 20 times 19 times 17 times 16 hanggang aabot ka ng times 1. And 18 factorial is equal to 18 times 17 times 16 hanggang aabot ka ng times 1. Okay. Baga ano yung sa itaas, multiplication, sa ibaba, multiplication din. All you need to do is to cancel all the common numbers, no, kasi multiplication lang siya. So, maiiwan is 20 times 19. Okay, tama ba, James Arquio? Eh, di-multiply please, 20 times 19? James? Nandiyan ka pa, James Arquio? Is 20 times 19 equal to 380? James? Yes? Is 20 times 19 equal to 380? Correct?
This is a normal na calculator, sir?
Yes.
Oh.
Eh, pwede man siya i-analyze as ano, formula na lang, no? Pero hindi siya applicable in all times kasi na mag-ano siya. Madali nyo lang answeran.
Opo, sir.
Okay, so 80. What's the answer, please? 20 times 380. So, very good. So, nakuha nyo rin siya kahit using the formula, no? Okay, so let's proceed na sa ating whiteboard. Now, let us think na ano ba, simple na example, no? What if merong tatlong tao, okay, name A, B, C, at merong dalawang chair, okay? ilang ways mo ma-arrange sila sa dalawang chair? That's a question, no? So, ibig sabihin, meron tayong object dito or person. Okay? So, klaro man siguro that there are three, right? And ilang slot or paglalagyan, I think klaro, that is represented by your chair, that is R. Okay? So, gagamitin natin later ito sa formula, no? But we want to prove kung tama yung ating formula. Okay, can we enumerate? Can I ask Jepson Maravilla?
Yes, sir.
Okay, kindly enumerate all, no?
Yung mga pairs, sir?
In how many ways, no? Arrangement okay, silang tatlong tao sa dalawang chair. So, ang sige, pangalan po, ng tao, A, B, C. Okay, para madali tayo, A, B, C.
Okay, sir. Sa
first chair, ilagay mo si?
First is A, B.
Okay, ilagay mo second si B. Okay, next.
Si A at saka C, sir.
Okay, dito na lang upuan. Next.
BA.
Okay, BA. Next.
BC.
BC. Next.
CA.
CA. Next.
CB, sir.
CB. Okay, meron pa ba?
Wala na, sir.
Okay, wala na. So, nalagay lahat. Wala na, no? Class, wala na. Wala nang, ano ito. So, let's count. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? 6. So, i-prove lang natin kung tama yung formula, no? So, using the formula, can you bring out your calculator, please? Okay, first. Jeffson? Can you press 3 and PR? Is the answer 6 also? Jeffson?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tama, no? So, using the formula, okay, pwede din, kung gusto nyo matagalan, ito yung formula sa ibaba, no? 6 ways pa rin yung answer. Okay? So, I hope nakuha, no? Okay, next tayo. Next. Okay, we're done with the first natin na whiteboard. Okay, kaya pa? Pagpatuloy na lang natin ito hanggang 8 class, ha? Then, on Thursday, we'll have an example. Baga, makinig lang muna kayo ngayon. Kasi delay kayo, eh. Delay kayo ng isang meeting because ang daming walang klase sa TTH, no? Okay, next tayo will be the fifth theorem. Okay, I will call Jason Balcos. Okay, open muna natin yung ating second, okay, this one, no? Second, so, na whiteboard, okay? Okay, theorem 5. Ang theorem 5 class, walang problema, no? Kasi pinakamadali sa palagay ko is because nakalagay yung word na circle. The number of permutations on an n distinct objects arranged in a circle is always equal to n minus 1 factorial. Okay? Example, in how many ways can 5 different trees be planted in a circle? Okay, just, let's analyze ilan ba yung object, distinct object. In this case, nakalagay 5 different. When you say distinct, magkakaiba, no? So just five, n is equal to 5, substitute na sa ating formula, n minus 1 factorial. That will give you 4 factorial. Okay? You all know that 4 factorial is equal to 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. That will give us 24. Okay? Using your calculator, just press 4. Then n factorial or factorial, then equal sign. Okay, tama ba? Nalito tuloy ako sa inyo.
Yes, sir.
Ako, Jason. Okay, Jason. Okay, sa RQ, AQ. Okay. Jason, no? Okay, punta tayo dito sa ating whiteboard, Jason, no? Okay, this is the example, Jason. May tatlong tao. Okay? Person A, B, C. May circular na table. Okay? Can we arrange them sa tatlong upuan? So, mauna si Jason.
A, sir.
A followed by
B,
followed by
P.
C, sir.
Okay. Meron pa bang iba? Wala na.
Meron pa, sir.
Okay. Can we tell us? Okay. Mauna si?
B, sir.
B? Followed by?
A, sir.
Okay. Followed by?
C, sir.
Meron pa ba?
Yes, sir.
Check natin na. Okay, can you tell us?
C, sir.
C? X?
A, sir.
A? X?
B, sir.
Okay. Meron pa ba?
Yes, sir.
Meron pa. O, sige. Okay. Mukhang mali ata yung formula na given, no?
Pwede tama na dahil, sir.
Sige, baka ano natin ba? That's... Hindi naman kayo class, no? Kung nagkamali, magkamali man tayo, it's okay, no problem. It's part of learning, no? Okay. So let us critique, no? Criticize natin na kung tama ba ito hindi. Ang sagot ni Jessel. Okay, wala na daw. Sabi ako na mali yung ano. Nag-stop na siya. Okay, there are three objects, okay? So 3 minus 1 will give you 2, right? And factorial, that is, Jason, 2 factorial is equal to?
2, sir.
2. Okay. Let us criticize, no? Critic natin. Now, mahirap pata ito i-analyze if we will not follow certain direction. Tama ba, Jason? It could be either clockwise or counterclockwise. Okay? Now, I will use clockwise, no? Clockwise. A, B, C. Isa. Okay? Distinct, no? This one, clockwise, A, B, C. The same? Jason?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Eliminate. Not the same.
Ah, gets an answer. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay lang yun. Okay, about this, Jason. A, C, B. Different?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, meron pa bang iba, Jason?
Wala na, sir.
Okay. So, very good. So, there are only two arrangements ang pwede mong magawa. No? Two factorial. Okay? Ayop, klaro. Next tayo. Kapit tayo matapos. Okay?
Sir, sir. Pero pwede na makamugan na, sir, no? Based lang sa formula, sir.
Yes. Yun yung points natin dito, no?
Yes,
since we are discussing the concept, okay, convince ko muna kayo kung tama o hindi, no? In a simple example, no? Because later, huwag na tayo gagawa nito, ha? It's not practical. It will consume time, no? Diretso na tayo gamit ng formula class. Diretso na tayo gamit ng calculator. Okay, theorem 6 tayo. Theorem 6... I will ask John Roy. John Roy, possible meron ka microphone, John Roy? Okay. Okay, theorem 6. Okay, the number of distinct permutation of n things of which n sub 1 are on of one kind, n sub 2 of second kind, n sub until n sub k of a kth kind. Okay, meron ganitong formula. Okay, how many different ways can 3 red, 4 yellow, and 2 bulbs be arranged in a string of Christmas tree lights. Okay. Just use immediately the formula, okay, 9 factorial, okay, because there are 9 Christmas tree lights, no? 9 sockets. No? There are 3 na red, 4 na yellow, then 2 na bulbs. No? Using your calculator, okay, may calculator ka ba? This time, hindi mo na siya magamit yung NPR at saka NCR. Gamitin nyo talaga yung function na factorial, no? Dito yung pinaka nalilito si Jan, diba? Sir, hindi talaga siya makuha. Error talaga siya, sir. Sir, no? Okay, can I ask you, Jan Roy, okay, may calculator ka na may factorial?
Up lang sa cellphone, sir. Na photomat, sir.
Okay, pero next time, bili tayo ng ano, ha? Scientific, kung meron na budget, kung may panahon. Okay, kasi gagamitin niyo sa ano niyo, sa kurso niyo talaga ang scientific calculator. Okay. Kasi sa cellphone, pwede mo siyang malagyan ng ano, ng open close parenthesis. Eh bawal man kayo mag-cellphone sa ano, sa board exam. Okay, sige pa ano daw, pa-try daw ng ano, John Roy ng cellphone. Is the answer 1260?
Kasi,
okay. Madali lang sa cellphone eh. Can I ask somebody may calculator class? Kasi during your board exam, bawal kayo mag-cellphone, no? Is the answer 1260? Yung merong scientific calculator? Anybody just say something on your microphone, please? Tama? Yes, no? Plus, sino may scientific calculator? Is the answer the same? 1,260.
Syntax error po, sir.
See, nag-syntax error sa kanya eh. Ano kayo problema niyo? Bakit ang syntax error?
Times na, sir. Ka ng...
Yes,
multiply. 1,260 po, sir.
Okay, can we explain na lang yung nakuha ng 1,260? Ang unang gipress natin is 9, tapos, can you explain please? Yung nakakuha na, I cannot see you. Okay, kung sino nagasalita. Okay, kapag naka-share screen ako.
Sir, tama sir.
Ako po, sir.
1,260 po.
Okay, can you explain na sa class, no? 9 factorial, 9, then press D, factorial, right? Then divide natin.
Yes po, sir, tapos, opo, tapos, nag, open parenthesis ako, tapos 3 factorial, tapos sine.
Times, no? Times. So don't forget the operation of multiplication. Okay. Hanggang.
Tapos 4, tapos hanggang times 2 factorial po, sir, tapos close parenthesis. Tapos okay, yun na po, sir.
Okay. Kasi nakalimutan din minsan yung multiplication na operation. Okay, so very good. Okay, next. Next tayo dito sa, let us simplify problem, no? Okay. For example, theorem 6 tayo class, no? In the word committee, okay, let us assume letters are objects. Okay? Object yung letter. Mas kanina nag-end ako. Tapos ka na dyan, Roy, no?
Ah, wala pa sa.
Ay, ikaw pala yung pending. Okay, dyan, Roy, kindly count the object in the word committee, please. Is it 9? Yes? 9, no? Correct?
Tama,
kasi, sir. Basi wrong spelling ko. Okay. In the word committee, you can classify them according to letters. Okay. Can you double-check na lang, John Roy, no? Isa lang yung C. Okay. Isa yung O, dalawa yung M.
Dalawang M.
One I, dalawang T, at dalawang E.
Dalawang E.
Okay. Using the formula, okay, ito yung formula, no? 9 factorial divided by for each of the kind. Okay, kaya ganito kahaba yung formula sa ibaba. Because there are how many kinds? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so the answer is 45,360 ways. Okay? So I hope nakuha nyo ito ng tama. Okay? It's another example. A general, dito tayo general. Yung madali lang, no? Yeah, listen muna natin ito. Okay, in the word B, let us assume itong letters as objects, no? Can we arrange them in the distinct arrangement? Okay. First, B. Okay, that's one. No? Second.
Was EB is a.
EB. Very good. Next.
That was EEB is a.
Okay, very good. EEB. Meron pa ba ibang genre?
Wala.
Okay. Can you count ilan? Ilang arrangements?
Tatlo, sir.
Okay, tatlo. There are three arrangements. Okay, using the formula, okay, 3 factorial because there are 3 objects here. Okay, there are 2 kinds. Okay, there are 2 letters here, no? Isang B at saka dalawang E. That is why ito yung formula. Okay? So that is why using the formula, okay, 3 ways talaga siya. Which is, general is correct, no? Using the manual method. Again, huwag na tayo mag-manual, ha? It will consume time. The rest of tayo gamit ng calculator, ano, ng formula or calculator. Okay na dyan, Roy. Okay. Next, okay. Theorem number 7. Okay, theorem number 7, it's almost the same with the theorem number 6. As you can see, okay, correctionan ko lang itong ating formula, no? May factorial ito kada partition, no? So in short, partition means i-ano mo siya, no? Paghiwalay-hiwalayin at ilagay kung for example, sa isang ilang slots, no? Meron siyang tawag nito condition here that if you will add all the partition, dapat always siya equal sa the number of objects. No? For example, how many ways can 7 people be assigned to 1 triple and 2 double rooms? For example, nasa nagpunta kayo ng seminar, nasa budget, dapat budget kayo, hindi kayo pwede mag-hotel. For example, doon kayo sa lodge, no? So, ang available doon sa lodge is isang triple. Ibig sabihin, tatlo lang yung pupwede doon. Tatlong participants. And naiwan doon, dalawang room na may capacity ng tagdalawa. So, ibig sabihin, sa isang room, dalawa lang. Dalawa may available, so apat ang pwede mo ilagay doon sa dalawang room. Okay, if we will check, okay, 3, then 2, then 2, that will give you 7. So, pasok siya sa theorem number 7. Okay? Now, use the formula. It's the same with the theorem number 6. Ito yung gagawin natin. So, in short, there are 210 ways na pwede mo siyang i-assign, no, sa iba't-ibang room. Okay? So, ito tayo sa ating whiteboard. Okay? Can I ask Vince at all, Kobe. Kobe pala. Kobe dyan?
Yes po, sir.
Okay. Kobe, for example, this situation, no? Tatlo kayong barkada. Example, naglaag mo, okay? Tapos, nag-overnight kayo. Okay, so, nag-inquire kayo, for example, doon sa resort na yon, okay? Kaya mag-overnight kayo, need to sleep, no? Ang available lang is isang double room at saka isang single room. Paano mo isa-assign yung sarili ninyo? Okay, you name yourselves as ABC. So, first room, double. Since, kindly, enumerate all. Okay, so first room, double. Dalawa yung ilagay. Sino ilalagay natin sa first room? Sino ilalagay natin sa first room?
A at saka B, sir.
Sama sila. So, single room, C lang. Okay? Next.
C.
Next arrangement, please.
C at B at saka C.
Sa double room. Para may sistema tayo, A pa rin siya. A pa rin yung mauna. Sa double room.
A
yung partner natin sa A. Yes, very good.
C po.
Then mag-solo C. Si B sa kabilang room. Okay. B. Another one. B. Mag-sabay
tapos
sila.
Tapos B.
A, no?
C, sir. A.
Okay, very good.
Okay.
Tama na yan. B at saka A. Next, B pa rin siya. Sinong partner natin kay B?
C.
C. Then magkasolo C. A.
A.
Okay, meron pa ba? Meron pa, wala na. Kobe. Nawala siya? Okay. So, if we will count, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, apat lang. So, but the answer is 3. Okay? May nagdoble ba?
Meron po, sir. B, A, tapos C.
May nagdoble. A, B, C. That's one. A, C, B. Ano doble dito? Okay, ito. Doble, oh. So, wala ito ha, no? Because they're the same, no? A, B, isang room. B, A, ano difference, no? They're the same. Okay, so, tatlo lang. Okay? So, using the formula, okay? Substitute sa formula, 3 factorial, divide natin sa first room, dalawa yung capacity niya, 2 factorial, sa kabilang room, isang capacity. That is why, tama itong manual natin. 3 lang na arrangements. Okay? Last. Okay. Parang pabay na ta. Okay, theorem number 8. Okay, ito yung pinakamahirap sa palagay ng estudyante, no? Sa palagay ko ng estudyante, ako mahirapan din ako dito, eh. Okay, theorem 8 is the number of combinations of n distinct objects taken at r at a time is ncr. Okay? So, it has the formula. Can you look at the formula? Magkaiba siya sa NPR class, ha? Anyway, you are ano naman, eh, allowed naman to use the calculator directly. Okay, combinations, arrangement is not important. For example, no, from 4 Republicans and 3 Democrats, find the number of committees of 3 that can be formed with 2 Republicans and 1 Democrat. Okay? Now, I told you a while ago, kapag combination siya, may assumption tayo that kumbaga yung pagpipilian mo are equally qualified. Okay? In this case, wala magong nakalagay. Okay, basta ang pipiliin mo lang, tatlo, you will create three members committee, okay? Basta yun sa tatlo na yun, dalawa doon, Republicans, disregarding kung sino sa apat, okay? At isang Democrat, disregarding kung sino sa tatlo. Okay, klaro, no? Ano, klaro, no? So, automatically, kapag ganito yung situation, this is combination, not permutation, Klaro ba? O nalilito pa rin kayo? Vince Aston, umandam. Vince? Wala siya
yes, sir.
Eh, klaro man, Vince, no? Yung yes, condition para ma-belong siya sa Theorem 8. Okay? Kapag yung situation equally qualified, okay? In this case, for Republicans. Now, may cases sa ating word problem, for example, for women, okay? Kung for women siya, disregarding kung sino, that is also combination. Example, another one, three men, no? Ano pa ba? Accounting teachers, okay? Walang nakalagay distinct accounting teachers, no? Or professors, no? Walang ganun. Okay? Just, in short, combination siya. Okay. How to solve this? Umandam, meron ka bang calculator?
Yes, sir.
Vince? Okay. Dalawa din kayong Vince. Magkasunod pa talaga kayo. Nicole at saka ni si Aston. Okay. Please bring out your calculator. Kay Lipress. Okay? Para mas madali nyo siya maintindihan. Okay? Ito ginagawa ko, no? Pipili ka sa apat. Okay? Ito yung first. No? Pipili ka ng dalawa pala. Okay? Yung sa second na number, itong 2, no? Pipili ka ng dalawa, ibig sabihin slot siya. Remember, I told you itong R slot, no? Yung bakante ba, na pwede mong punan, no? Dalawa yung slot dito. Pipili ka ng dalawa out of 4. Kindly press 4 and CR 2, Vince, lihog daw.
Tapos na, sir.
What's the answer, please?
6.
Okay, 6. Very good. Okay. Kindly press kay dalawa lang yun sa committee. Kailangan tatlo, no? Kailangan pa ng isa. Okay. Pipili ka ng isa, isang slot for Democrat out of 3 Democrats. Okay. 3C1, please.
Three, sir.
Okay, very good. 3, no? Now, in solving this one, okay, this is combination of Theorem 8 at saka Theorem 1. Okay, just apply the multiplicative rule, no? Multiplication rule. Okay, I hope klaro ha. That is why nga, bakit siya na-multiply, no, ng ganito? Okay? So, kindly multiply, so that is 3 times 6, that will give you 18. So, there are 18 possible committees. Okay? So, klaro, no? Okay, dito tayo sa whiteboard bins, no? Okay, Vince, si ano na lang, si next na tayo kay Lumoks para makatawag kay lahat. Vince, Nicole, may microphone ka, please.
Okay. Wag lang yung naka-rejoin sa iyo na internet, sorry na.
Asa di ka karoon, Vince?
Nakudrit sa baloy, sir. Data lang, sir.
Barangay, asa kang barangay?
Alabel.
Alabel. Maano na ako, masabtan ako. Walang bill ka. Okay, ano siya? I hope maitindihan pa rin ako, Vince. Hindi man ako putol-putol, Vince, no?
Hindi man, sir.
Okay. Now, for example, there are 3 persons, no? In a group. Okay? Now, in what way you can consider them as one? Can you consider, I will rephrase the question. Will you consider them as one in terms of arrangement? Okay? Itong tatlo sa isang grupo. In terms of arrangement, okay? Will you consider them one? In what way? Or 3 different or more different, ano ba? Magkakaiba yung arrangement niya? Okay, naiintindihan yung question ko. In what situation, okay, may tatlong tao na makonsider mo sila na kahit i-disarrange mo sila, okay, isa pa rin sila. Again, my question is, tatlong tao, in what situation makonsider mo sila na isa? Okay, kahit mauna si A, mauna si B, mauna si C.
Ang weird ang naisip ko, sir, ba? Pero ang
gusto wag lang bastos,
Ang Powerpuff Girls, sir, kung masing kinsa mauna si Buttercup or si Blossom or si Bubble, sir, isa gyapon sila, sir.
Okay.
Powerpuff Girls gyapon sila.
That's correct, no? Very good, no?
I-name mo sila, sir.
Ano daw?
Name mo sila, sir.
Kumbaga, Powerpuff Girls, kahit i-disarrange mo sila, isa pa rin silang grupo. Okay? So in short, you will not make this like ABC, okay? Powerpuff kasi sino gani yan sila. When I was younger, young pa man ko, no? Parang Cartoon Network mag sa balay, no? Kalimot ko sa pangalan nila. Kinsa yan ito?
Si Buttercup, Bubbles, Blossom.
Blossom, tatlo, no? Maski disarrange mo sila, Powerpuff Girls gapon sila, no? So, it's considered one. Okay? Vince, Nicole, kindly press okay, your calculator. May set yung calculator ka?
Apo, sir.
Okay. Ilang slots lahat sa grupo nila? Ilang
tatlo
slots?
Po. Tatlo, tatlo po.
Okay, so there are obviously tatlo silang magkakaibang tao, no? So, R is equal to 3. Then, N is equal to 3. Okay? Kindly press N, C, 3 and CR 3, please. What's the answer?
I wait lang, sir.
Okay, 3 and CR 3. I think if you're using your scientific calculator daw, you need to press anong gatawag ng class? Yung second na, no? Yung sa ilalim? Mode ba or shift? Kasi naisa ibaba daw siya ng ano, na isang function para magamit yung function na yun.
NCR, sir?
NCR.
3...
Shift divide sa akin po.
Yung sa ibang calculator, shift divide. 3, basta hanapin nyo yung NCR, then 3. Kasi ano man, ang R is equal to 3 eh. Answer, please.
Pila ganun ano, sir? Ang R, sir?
3, tatlo. Tatlong slots man.
Ang N, sir?
3 din. Tatlo ba sila?
1, sir.
Okay, very good. Okay? The answer is one way. Okay? Iba yung answer kapag i-press nyo yung NPR. Okay? Kapag i-press nyo yung NPR, the answer is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? 6. Kaya lang, the problem is you consider them as in a group with equal qualification. Eh. Okay? So, ang tanong ko, magkagrupo bang ABC? Yes. Magkagrupo bang ACB? Yes. Magkagrupo bang BAC? Yes. O Powerpuff bang BCA? Yes. Powerpuff ba yung CAB? Yes. Okay? So, iisa lang silang grupo. So, it means that arrangement is not important. Okay? Vince, kindly press daw 3, NPR 3 daw. What's the answer? Is it 6? Yes, no? 6, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, 6. Very good, 6. Kapag yung situation, okay, example, tatlong members sa isang grupo, i-arrange mo sila sa isang hilera, okay, mag-ibang situation niya eh, okay, ilang arrangement mo ang pwedeng gawin sa kanila, okay? So doon pa lang, mauna si Andy, kay Berna, kay Carlo, okay, is different. Okay? Depende siya sa situation ng problem, okay? Kung ano yung required, okay? Again, kapag theorem number 8, meron tayong assumption, equally qualified. Okay? Yung ganung klaseng concept. Okay, we're done, no? I will stop the recording. Okay, thank you for your participation, class. So, let's rest.